Okay, so that was weird. It said it was streaming.
That is weird.
It said end stream, and then it went back to go live. Sorry about that. But good morning, everyone. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Hope you guys had a great week. He's risen. So we highly recommend you take some time in your day and just thank God for all that he's done.
Yes.
Especially on today. Let's try that again.
From before the beginning of time itself, God existed, and he created everything in the entire world. He formed the universe. He spoke light into existence just with his voice. He did all of these amazing things that make the world the way it is, how we know it today. And he made mankind, and he made mankind in his own image. And mankind sinned. And mankind fell short, and mankind rebelled against him. And we made the mistakes, and we make mistakes all the time. But God has this love for us in his heart that he sent his son onto the earth to die on the cross and be risen the third day for us, to save us from our sin, to save us from ourselves. And he loved us that much. And it is just amazing to think about how he puts his hand out for us. Whenever we are in need, whenever we are feeling scared or lost, he is there for us. And it is just amazing to see his grace in work every day of our lives.
Yeah.
Anointing, hallelujah.
But as they went to move the stone, they saw that they were not alone. For Jesus Christ is risen, hallelujah. 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 Our family has really grown up with, or well, the three of us, we've really grown up listening to and learning about the gospel story and the resurrection, and this year was, like, kind of different, because, like, Bunky was telling us yesterday of how, or was it Friday? Of how this year was different. She could, like, tell how much He suffered for us. We took a look at the story of what happened. We watched The Passion of the Christ, which is becoming a tradition that we do every Good Friday. And it's just like how much that Jesus suffered for us. He lived this life that was free from sin. He was the perfect human. He did everything right. He was exactly what God wanted us to be. He was perfect, and he took himself, he gave himself up for us, and it's the reason we do communion. Take from my body and eat, or take this and eat, for this is my body, and drink this, which is my blood. And he took his body, he took himself, he gave himself up for us like a sacrifice, because he is. And he paid that ultimate price so that we could have a shot at being closer to God, to being forgiven. And because of that mercy, we are able to be where we are today. And we are able to have a relationship with a God who loves us, and we are able to be saved from us. It says in the song that Jesus saved us from ourselves, hallelujah. And it could not be more true. I don't think I need to tell anyone, and they're going to be shocked, that you sin. All of us do. I mean, all of us fail. All of us fall. All of us have these flaws to us, and that we can't help it. We're human. And we can try, and we can fail, and we can keep doing that, and it's just this thing that we're always going to do because we're human. It's because it's what we do. But through God, we are able to try to do better. We are able to know right from wrong and be able to choose his path. And his path isn't easy. And it says that in the Bible. Like, you don't have to explain that. But it gives us a chance to have a relationship with God. And we don't deserve that. We are the people who mocked Jesus as he was hurt and tortured and beaten before he died. We are the people who did that to him. Because through our sin, we're no better. And because of his sacrifice, we can still have a chance of being better. We can still have a chance of having a relationship despite all that we do. Yeah. I forgot where
I was going. No, that was really good.
Midnight.
A comfort to us. In this song, there's a part that said, "The middle of two thieves that says everything." And it does say everything. He died on the cross for me, for you, for us. It is personal. He died for us. But he rose today. He is risen and alive today. Today, he conquered the grave. It's amazing.
It is beautiful. The devil left in the set of one. God has lost his only son. The brightest star no longer shines. Finally, this world is mine. Then he gathered all his demons near. He said, "We've conquered love with fear."
Mary.
tell their differences are all they'll see. Black and white and rich and poor to justify their holy war. Meanwhile, back at the cross, all is not lost. Forgiveness is bought with each drop of his blood. It falls to always see the entire picture of what happened that day. I mean, yes, we all know what happened. We all know that Jesus went through all of this pain and suffering and died on the cross to save us and to pay the punishment for our sins. And then he rose again on the third day. But I don't think we always see the entire picture. I think since we celebrate it every year, we don't always remember just how miraculous it is, just how in awe of it we should be. I don't think everyone sees that every time, because we are a lost people. We are lost sheep, and he came down to earth to save us, to find us, and to bring us back, and to provide a way that we could be found, that we could be his, and that we could be with him, despite having all of these flaws and all of these sins that we have. He came down, and he went through all of these terrible, terrible things that no one should ever have to go through, and he never even did anything wrong. He went through all of these things purely because he loved us, because he loves us. Just let that sink in. He loves you. He loves me. He did this because he loves us. And he went through all of that, those terrible things, because he loves us. And he did this. He came down so that he could make this world a better place, so that we could one day go up there and be with him and see him and just be in awe of him all over again. Because this man, this person came down, went through that suffering, because he loves us. And that's something that we shouldn't just remember this weekend. This should be something we remember every single day of our lives, because he did this for us. And this should be something impacting our every single move, because he loves us. And that's amazing in itself.
Taught the sun where to stand in the morning, and who told the ocean you can only come this far, and who showed the moon where to hide till evening, whose words alone can catch a falling star. Same God that spins things in orbit runs to the weary, the worn, and the weak.
the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken. They conquer death to bring me victory. Now I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. All of creation testify. Let this life within me try. I know my Redeemer. He lives to take away my shame, and he lives to forever I'll proclaim that the payment for my sin was the precious life he gave. But now he's alive and there's an empty grave. Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me try. I know my Redeemer.
You were supposed to say something after.
Oh, I was?
Yeah.
It's a beautiful, it's just, it's really everything about what we're remembering here, what we're trying to think about these past 3 days is just amazing on so many levels, because not only did he go through all of that suffering and all of these things to save us, but he also, this is the same God who put the universe in its place and showed where all of the animals should rest their heads and where the birds can nest down for the winter. This is the same God who tames the ocean by speaking to it. And he is the same God who rose again the third day. The third day when he conquered death and stepped out of that grave, he was alive again. And this is not only a miracle, so amazing and incredible that he conquered death and he conquered the grave and he came back to save us. But this is also a resemblance of how when we die, when our lives on this earth are over, we will go and live in the place he went to prepare for us. Because he lived, we will live. Mm-hmm. And we won't have this second death. We will go up and live with him in his kingdom that he prepared for us, the same one that he spoke about in the gospel, that kingdom, that one, just that kingdom. We will go up there and be in that kingdom with him, because he died and he came back to life and he prepared that place for us. So because our Redeemer lives, we can live. And that is just wow, just wow. That is amazing that we have this opportunity, this privilege to go up there and be with him at the end of our lives on this earth. Mm-hmm. And that is something we should remember every single day.
He is the teacher. He's the father. He's amazing.
Well, we are going to wrap up with a quick prayer today. And then we're going to head over to Mr. Josh's at Dig Deeper Ministries. I'm sure he has a beautiful teaching prepared for tonight, or today, this morning, not night. And we're hoping that you will be able to join us there, because we really enjoy listening to him and we get a lot out of it, and we hope you will too. Mm-hmm. So if you'll join us for a quick prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for everything that you've blessed us with. We thank you for our opportunities here to praise and worship you with this community that we're in. And we thank you for our family and our entire lives. We thank you for everything you've blessed us with. We thank you for our farm and our family and our friends. And we thank you. And today especially, we thank you for your son. We thank you that you sent him down to this earth to teach and to help and to heal and to serve others and to show us as an example how we should live our lives, how we should go about and how we should treat others, how we should serve them and help them and spread your word. And we also thank you that he came down and he went through all of that suffering, and he went through all of that pain and that struggle, and he died on that cross in a painful and terrible way so that we could live, so that we could be saved, and so that we would be able to come before you and pray and to speak with you. And we thank you that he gave us that opportunity by laying down his life for us. And we thank you. And we thank you that he rose again on the third day, and that he conquered the grave, and that he conquered death. And we thank you for loving us and for caring about us. We thank you for all of the miracles that you show us in our everyday lives. And we thank you that you loved us enough to send down your son for us. And we thank you that he went back up and that he's preparing a place for us. And we thank you for everything that's happening. And I want to pray that you would heal some of the people in our community who have lifted up their prayer requests, and that you would help them feel peace and to feel your hand and to be healed or to feel your presence. And I pray that you would help those people in this community and that you would show them your love. And I pray that today especially, that people would just stop in their days, in their busy lives, and that they would think about the miracle that you performed with your son coming back to life on the third day, on Resurrection Sunday, that people would stop to think about this, and that they would just go, wow, he did that for me. And I pray that you would pour your love into their hearts so that they could have that realization and that remembrance, and that we would be able to all just have peace today. Have peace knowing that you came down, that you poured your love out on this earth for us. And we just thank you, and we are in awe of that. And Lord, I pray that you would protect us and protect all of the ministries and all of the people that are here in our community, and that you would keep them safe and keep them healthy, and that you would keep them following your word and remembering what you did for us. And I pray that you would continue to show your love to all of us and show us which path you want us to take, and that you would close the doors and open them when you see fit, that we would go the right way and follow the right path, and that it would lead us to you. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, sorry.
He is risen.
It is 11:06, so we're a little bit late. It is
negative 1 minute to get your coffee and head over to dig deeper.
Exactly.
He is risen. Praise the Lord.
So we highly recommend you go over to Dig Deeper Ministry after this. He's a really great teacher, and we love hearing what he has to say. But have a happy Sunday, happy Resurrection Sunday. He is risen and he is alive, and he's just one prayer away. So, mm-hmm. How do you?
Well, thank you guys so much for coming, and have a blessed rest of your day. Happy Easter, and God bless everyone.